गुड आफ्टरनून टू आर रिस्पेक्टेड टीचर्स स्टूडेंट्स एंड वर्चुअल ऑडियंस. इट इज माई ग्रेट ऑनर टू प्रेजेंट माई वर्क इन फ्रंट ऑल ऑफ यू. आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक प्रोफेसर नवीद एंड इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ जियोलॉजी टू गिव मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माई वर्क ऑन स्ट्रेटिग्राफिक एवोल्यूशन ऑफ द इंडर डेल्टा. Indus Delta and interplay of sea level changes, tectonics and sediment supply. As several studies advocate that rapid quaternary climate changes relative to the general response time of fluvial system makes climate and sea level the foremost driver over the quaternary time scale. So for this, an understanding of a fluvial system and its response to allogenic control factors such as sea level changes, tectonic movement and sediment supply is important for research regarding the sequence stratigraphy and the sedimentary geology. The fluvial system is also a crucial component of a source to sink system, which links the sources to the receiving basin, that is the sinks. The evolution of the Indus Delta offers a rare example for studying the interplay of sea level changes, sediment supply and tectonism, and especially the fluvial response to sea level changes. Moreover, the understanding of the evolution of the Indus Delta in the recent past years has also important socio-economic implications of the area where huge urbanization, agriculture activities, irrigation and damming are happening. If you see this slide, which represent the source to sink cartoon and also exhibit the interplay of allogenic and also autogenic processes with sedimentary deposits. Climate, tectonics and sea level controlling the accommodation space and also the amount of the sediments to fill the basin. In the lower picture, if you see the study area which has been established to analyze the catchment area for depositional system of a selected times scale which quantify the sources of the Indus River and sediment preservation in the Indus Delta and sediment furtherly sinks to the Indus fan. The key objective of this study is to simulate the Indus Delta evolution and geometry of the sequence deposition by considering the sea level variations with geological processes, for example tectonic subsidence and climatic changes with continental deposits over the scale of 200 kilo years before present to the present day and into the near futures. Resultantly, a 3D sedimentary model which can be used to estimate the fluvial deposition of the Indus Delta and interpret the sequence deposition in response to sea level changes. After obtaining this objective, we will be able to set a perception on the development of the Indus Delta in quaternary and summarizes the sedimentary processes that operate to build up the Indus Delta. The Indus River is one of the most fascinating river in the Himalayan region, and it is the oldest river in that region, which forms the largest subaerial delta and submarine fan. Fluvial sediment fluxes in the Indus Delta plain are among the highest in the world, and sediments driven effects on the sea level in this area are large. The region representing the dramatic influence of climates, tectonics and sea level changes in that area. Indus River is the principal and one of the largest river in the western Himalaya, which is about 3000 km long and started from the Manasarovar Lake near the sacred mountain Kailas in Tibet Plateau, and having the elevation about 5,500 meters. There are a number of large eastern and western distributaries which fed the main Indus Channel and giving the prominent water and sediment discharge. The Indus River system was initiated about the 50 million years ago after the first collision of the Indian and Eurasian plates. The Indus Delta, which is also the constituent of the area, comprises the seventh largest in the world. The fan-shaped Indus Delta, up by the high discharge and large quantities of sediment load down from upland and mountain areas. The delta has undergone the strong bidirectional monsoonal winds from the southwest during summer and from the northeast during the winter. What makes the Indus Delta unique is the fact that it experiences the highest wave energy of any river in the world. During delta front receives more wave energy in a single day than the Mississippian Delta receives over a whole year, which is about 9 kilojoule per hour. The Arabian Sea has a wide interest because of its biogeochemical importance and influence of upsurging during the southwest summer monsoon and convecting reversing of water masses during the northeast winter monsoon. The southwest monsoonal winds are connected to the intertropical convergent zone, which causes the intense rainfall to the Indian subcontinent. And during the northeast monsoon, the western continental margin of the India has a major control on paleoproductivity, which was dominant in the last glacial cycle. Thar Desert is also the constituent of that area. The fluvial and aeolian system exchange the sediments at large spatial scales over the Indus Basin. The lower Indus Basin and the delta recycle the sediments from the southwest northeastwardly into the desert during the summer monsoon. Likewise, the lower Indus Delta catches the sediments from the desert during the winter monsoon. And the Thar Desert expanded towards the southwest direction after the last glacial maximum. Pakistan stands the border of the Eurasian, Indian and Arabian plates. Most of the Pakistan comprises of eastern Arunachal fault system that contains the Indus Basin, and major part of Pakistan is divided into different stratigraphically and tectonically divided sections on the basis of orogenic history. Number one, upper Indus Basin and northern mountain areas. Number two, Mesozoic to early tertiary fault beds that are the Kirthar and Suleiman fault beds, axial belt and Indus platform and fortip, our study area lying that region, and Indus offshore and Makrana Krishnery zone. Indus platform and fortip contains wide zones of upwards and downwards. If you see in that figure, there are three upward zones, Tata Hyderabad High and Tharparkar High. And also there are downward zones, which are the Nawabshah slope, lower Indus trough and Nabisar slope. If we see the quaternary geology of that area, having the sequence of variety of depositional environments, including fluvial deposits, peatmoss deposits or debris, aeolian deposits, evaporites, salt lakes, deltaic, shoreline and coastal deposits, and also the deep marine deposits. The stratigraphic column of the our target timescale is proposed, also proposed by the Kazmi, and our model will validate this. The stratigraphic column presents the formation proposed by Kazmi according to our timescale, may be expressed as the Larkana formation, which can be exhibited as deposition of silt in the Piedmont zones due to the precipitation during the first glacial period. After that, Nabisar formation, which consists of deltaic hard clay, laminated with interbattery lenses of fine sand, abundant mollusk shells, which is deposited during the first interglacial period. And the Tundojam formation, which having the more thickness among the all, consists of channel fill deposits, fine to coarse grained sand with pebbles and cobbles, having class of Eocene limestone and Sivalik sandstone. It is formed by the infilling of incised valleys after the last glacial maximum and having the thickness at some places more than 200 meter and also at some places 500 meter. The morphological model can be expressed by the dam and also the satellite images. If we see the dam model, which is obtained by the SRTM3 version 2, contains global coverage in 1:1 degree with approximate resolution of 90 by 90 kilometer by using the raster data. And it shows the typical S-shaped curve of the Indus Delta Plain, and the width of the upper delta plain is about 150 kilometer from Kirthar Highlands to the Thar Desert, and the lower tidal delta is about 190 kilometer wide. The lowest elevation area is more susceptible, having the elevation about 70 meter above sea level, and area having elevation less than about 250 meter are highly affected by the floods, and the area which having the elevation 500 meter is less affected by the floods. The dam model can further be used to look the geomorphic features like slope of the area and also relief of the area. The slope of the area is very gentle and relief is the even. And we can also identify the different channel geomorphologic features like oxbows, scroll bars, cutoffs, and meander scars. And we can also identify the paleo stream channels which exhibit the distributive pattern of the lower Indus Delta. The two satellite images are used to explain the morphological feature of the Indus Delta. The number one is the MSS multi-scanner system, and it is used to describe the shape and structure which depends on the geomorphic and lithostructural properties. It also identifies the abundant channels. If you see in the lower picture, there are 9 abundant channels which supplied the sediments in the past to the Indus fan. And there are numerous minor creeks and also the some major creeks which intruded by the tidal creeks. We can see in the upper picture, and we can divide it into 3 zones. The first zone is relatively stable. The second zone, which is the central zone, is the highly affected by the tidal creeks and salt lake intrusions. And the third zone at the most eastern part, it has the profound changes and tidal creeks are extended about the hundreds of kilometers. This satellite image can exhibit the channel variation and also the channel width variations. The reducing trend of the channel widths infer that the discharge and load are continuously decreasing after the man-made activities such as the barrages and dams, and river mouth widens also due to the erosion of by the tides. The field excursion conducted at the area and the scope of the field work to record the lithology, sedimentary structures, grain sizes, and hydraulic variables, which was further used to make the input parameters for the software. According to the field analysis, the upper delta plain deposited by the overflow of Indus Channel and its tributaries. Having the alternate bedding of sand and mud with fining upward sequence, and the lower delta contains coarsening upward vertically stacking pattern of sedimentary facies. We can infer the four types of lithofacies. Number one, the channelly sand. Number two, sand dominated heterolithic bedding and clay dominated heterolithic bedding, and the freshwater peats. In the lower delta plain, silt or finer fractions are more than 50%. The upper pictures showing the bedding styles of cliffs at banks of the Indus River near the Kotri Barrage, showing upward fining sequence. The B diagram showing the alternating bedding of clay and sand. The C diagram showing the oxbow at Tundojam area, which having intense bioturbation. And the D diagram showing the old terraces near the Matiari area. The lower picture exhibiting the physically sedimentary structures, including the slum structures and flacers, and also the ball and pillow structure, and also showing the planar lamination at Jampir area. Biogenic sedimentary structures, there are bioturbation at Tundojam area, burrows at Matiari area, and mud clast at also Matiari area. The coarser detrital materials from the Kifthar foreland belt also showing here. Different paths in the lower picture, there is showing different paths along the channel from Kotri to KT Bandar Creek. It shows the channel meandering at Matiari area, highland outcrops of the sandstone which feeding also the Indus channel and also Indus delta. And also the lugworms of KT Bandar Creek at the edge of the delta. The water and sediments are two fundamental interventions of a fluvial system which establish the profile of the river, volume and overall morphology of the river on different spatial and time scales. The climate of the Indus is arid to semi-arid with seasonal varying precipitations, and Indus Delta has biannual and bidirectional monsoonal cycles. One is the southwest summer monsoon from May to September, and other is the northeast winter monsoon from November to February. The dramatic reduction of discharge and load for different periods can shown after engineering structures constructed on the Indus River. A conceptual model has built on the analysis of morphological model and sedimentological model, and the Indus River has a dispersive pattern which feeds the delta floodplain. Upper delta is fluvial dominated, and the lower delta contains coastal zone, shoreline, and inner Indus shelf. Coarser to fine-grained terrigenous sediments are dominant over the Indus Delta with high abundance of quartz and feldspar with least carbonate content. Coarser detrital material derived from the Kifthar Highlands and Laki Highland, and also from the Hub River which flows from the Las Bela Valley. Western coast is retrieving while eastern coast is erosive, which is highly susceptible. Northeast margin covered by the sand dune subsidence and subsidence increasing in the eastern direction. The stratigraphic forward modeling is a simulating technique that endeavors to rerun the all physical processes in which sediments eroded, transported, and deposited over the different time scale, more useful when seismic and well data are not available. This picture is showing the workflow of the our model. The software, which is named as SetSim10, is used, which is a 3D numerical hydraulic stratigraphic forward modeling amalgamation that simulates the clastic sedimentary cycle by using Navier-Stokes equation. Firstly, we built the paleotopography and also identified the sediment sources of the Indus Delta. Dominant terrigenous sediments input from the Indus River control the Indus Delta plain. In the southwest, adjacent Laki and Kifthar Highlands contain tertiary outcrops which fed the detrital material to the Indus Delta. In southwest, the Hub River flows into the Arabian Sea from the Bela Ophiolite Zone and Las Bela Valley. Maximum distribution of the aeolian particles from the eastern side occurred after the last glacial maximum. Topographic surface of the Indus Delta plain is gentle, and as there is no major tectonic activity evident since 200 kilo years. The subsidence analysis conducted by the user defined parameters and subsidence has been driven mostly by the associated flexure belt and emplacement of the thrust belt. Increase in accommodation space and lateral migration is associated to the thrust related asymmetric subsidence, which influence the river profile, lithology, coarse migration and topography. The present day thickness and type of lithology give the better idea for the subsidence analysis. And we refer some values from past work. Like seismic data shows that subsidence is continuous and the river flow in the axis of the 4D nadran of Severn, which is apex of the delta. Subsidence rate of Indus Foreland Basin was about 0.3 to 0.5 mm per year during Pleistocene period. And since 9.8 kilo years, the lower Indus Delta has experiencing more subsidence, which is about 0.5 to 2.5 mm per year. And these values are manipulating on the transform software. Change in sea level is the key factor which shapes the sedimentary record and climate changes in this study. Since 200 kilo NM, four glacial and interglacial cycles have been occurred. During the last interglacial period, sea level was 8 times more than the present. At that time, at the time of last glacial maximum, sea level was lowest about 130 meter. And sea level was 2 meter higher during mid-Holocene, about 6 kilo NM than the present. At Karachi Gorge, the sea level is rising at the rate of 1.1 millimeter per year. Higher sea level depicting high rainfall and flow rate, and subsequently sediment discharge also increasing. And during lower sea level, rainfall and sedimentary supply also becomes less. Waves take part in the sorting and redistribution of the sediments. In tidal flats, sediments redistributed by the waves energy. And Indus shoreline reflects the effect of wave action, as there are no extensive beaches, lack of beach ridges deposits, and the shape of wide shoreline is curved and slightly indented. Waves and longshore currents transfer the sediments up to hundreds of meters in a day, and they can be affected up to a depth of 15 meters. These are the other input parameters and simulation carried out completely after adjusting the input parameters repetitively until a good match with geological observations. This movie is exhibiting the simulation which runs from a total time period of 205 kilo NM. That is 200 kilo NM before present to till now, and for 5 kilo years into the future. We display interval of 1 kilo year. This movie is showing the evolution stages after each 5 kilo year, displaying the sediment deposition and sea level fluctuations. This simulation mimics the sedimentary processes and is consistent with the sequence stratigraphic concepts. And we have choose the four grain sizes, the coarser, the medium to fine, and finer, and the finest, which is the clay. Due to the lack of well and seismic data of quaternary deposits of the Indus Delta, the validation carried out by comparing the thickness with Kazmi's profile, morphology and surfacial facies by satellite images, and grain size with the field observations. A reasonable thickness generated by the SATSIM, which correlated with the thickness profile in the center of the Indus Delta as proposed by the Kazmi. And having the three formations, Larkana Formation, Tundojam Formation, and Navisar Formation. The present day delta plain contains the fluvio-deltaic inland deposits at the elevation of greater than 10 meter above the sea level, coastal and shoreline deposits greater than 0 meter elevation, and near to open marine deposits below the sea level. The position of the shoreline and the coastal area, continental and marine territory, and the water covered area are well correlated in this model, which can be validated by the satellite image. This video is showing the stacking pattern of the Indus Delta. If we see from 200 to 130 kilo NM, which is the low stand period, and sedimentation pattern is somehow similar all the whole time period from 200 to 130 kilo NM. And shoreline moved seaward rapidly by the forced regression in response of falling of sea level. And from 130 to 60 kilo NM, which is the first interglacial, and it depicts the high stand period, and sea level rose at that time. Climate conditions were warm and wet, sedimentation increasing, and maximum flooding surface can be set at the 120 kilo NM. From 60 to 180, from 60 to 18 kilo NM, which is the second low stand period, and sea level again fall. Last glacial maximum was in between 20 to 18 kilo NM, and sediments bypassing the shelf and shifted towards the basin floor. From 18 kilo NM to till now and into the near future of 5 kilo years, which is also second high stand period, and sea level abruptly began to rise with high amplitude. Monsoon conditions were intensified, and there is second maximum flooding surface is set as 6 kilo NM. From 18 kilo NM to early Holocene, it is the period of transgressive phase, and the mid Holocene to recent is the period of high stand. Subaerial accommodation space producing by relative increase in the elevation of shoreline. The depositional sequence can be inferred by this diagram. In the upper diagram, the north, south, and west is subaerial and subaqueous depositional phases from inland to marine. We can see four stages of evolution with depositional sequences and significant surfaces. The first is the glacial period, second, first interglacial, second glacial, and second interglacial period. In the lower picture, lithofacies cross section at the center of the delta showing different stacking depositional sequences and significant surfaces with different grain size particle distribution during sea level change from 200 kilo NM to the future 5 kilo years. In the upper diagram, north, south, and west is cross section of paleo water depth facies showing continental and marine depositional sequences above and below the sea level. And wave base is at 15 meters, which is brown in color. In the lower diagram, north, south, and west is pseudo seismic cross section showing the alternation of depositional layers of 1000 years, displaying the stacked sequence and frequent depositional and erosional features, discontinuous and patched coeval layers. Total sediment thickness can be exhibited by the isopack maps, which contain four grain sizes: coarse, medium to fine sand, silt, and clay. Time duration has partitioned according to the sea level changes from first interglacial to the second interglacial. A and C diagram showing the sediments become thicker oceanward when sea level fall during the first period and the second glacial period. In B and D diagram, sediments become thicker landward when sea level rise during first and second interglacial periods. The northeast delta and shoreline platform showing the maximum thickness in D, E, and F diagram. This is the sand and clay fraction distribution over the Indus Delta plain. The spatial variability of floodplain deposited by the fluvial channel and sand sediments deposited in the upper delta, while the lower delta shows more variability such as the infilling of incised channels by silt and clay. Laterally, the delta extended towards east and thickness also increasing eastward. The pseudo wells can be inferred by the sedimentation rate in quaternary period. which is controlled by the sea level changes. Higher sea level depicts the higher sedimentation, while the lower sea level depicts the lower sedimentation and erosion. 10 pseudowells have been generated from the simulation model to encounter the deposition rate from proximal to distal area in the delta plain since 200 kN to the next 5 kilo-years. And time here also time duration partitioned by the sea level changes and 5 intervals according to sea level variations. The profile also set as the north, south and west, east. This is the statistics of the pseudo wells which are get from the SETSIM model. Maximum deposition occurred during 130 to 60 kN overall in all encountered wells. In pseudo well 2 and 5, negative deposition occurred during second glacial period, which is 60 to 18 kN. And in first glacial period, sedimentation continued partly due to the high precipitation conditions of the Indian monsoon. For the next 5 kilo years, pseudo well 2, 3 and 4 showing the positive deposition. And at pseudo well 5, erosion occurred due to the tidal action. In pseudo well 7, negative deposition or erosion occurred during the second glacial period. And for the next 5 kilo years, pseudo well 7 and 9 showing the positive deposition. In second interglacial period, which is from 18 kN to till now, the sedimentation rate is maximum among all the time. These pie diagrams showing the percentage of the sedimentation according to the time period, which is partitioned according to the sea level changes. This is the sedimentary budget table, which is used to describe the sediment input from sources and predicts output to the sinks into the Indus span. Rate of change of sediment depends on the amount of sediment taken into the system compared to the amount of sediments left the system. The simulation follows the law of conservation of mass, which is sediment in plus sediment eroded is equal to sediment in fluid element plus sediment deposited and plus sediment out. The Indus coast, its development and vulnerability. Erosion along the coast linked to the cyclic or continuous process such as waves, tides, longshore currents. And these processes usually lead to a physical balance between erosion of sediments in one side of the coast and accumulation in the another side. The nested models in the SETSIM have been generated for the coastal zone from west to east to resolute its development during 200 kN to the present. The Indus coast can be divided into three stages of its evolution. From 200 to 110 kN, from 110 kN to 18 kN and 18 kN to till now. The eastern delta is thicker than the western part and coarser fractions are increasing in the western part. This scenario showing the future susceptibility of the Indus coast into the next 5 kilo years. As sea level is still rising for 1 millimeter per kilo year due to the thermal expansion of the Indian Ocean, melting of the continental glaciers due to the rising temperature relating to the global greenhouse effect, and also because of higher sediment buffering of the Indus Basin. Since the English colonization, the Indus River flows has been hindered by the several engineered structures. There is 60 to 70% reduction in discharge and sediment load. In the left diagram, if we see this in case of the static sea level, there is relatively stability. While in the right diagram, if the sea level is continuously rising, then there are more risk at the coast and more erosion can be occurred. The conclusions of this study. During low stand period, forced regression occurred by falling sea level and sediments by passing the delta plain, causing the delta to be shifted seaward. And during the high stand period, sediments deposited on the delta plain positively, The early high strand characterized the aggradation and the later high strand further accelerated the sediment progradation. Sea level fell during the glacial period from 200 to 130 kN and 60 to 18 kN, and in CN occurred on the delta plain. While the Indus River partly continued to the flow by westerly precipitation of Indian monsoon during the low strand, and terrigenous flux increased from 130 kN to 60 kN and 18 kN to the present and into the near future. Sea level is relatively high, and during these high strands, continuous aggradation occurred in the delta plain with infilling of incised valleys. The northeastern delta has a thickness up to about 175 meters, and the central delta plain has relatively less thickness, which is in between 75 to 150 meters. While the maximum aggradation occurs at shoreline platform, where thickness is more than 200 meters. The sedimentary budget can be described by the cumulative deposition for the four grain sizes: coarser, medium sand, silt, and clay. The Indus coast developed in three different stages of its evolution. The western coast is retreating due to the local uplifting and sedimentation, while eastern coast is deluged due to tidal intrusion and lack of sediment supply. These are the important references which are used in these studies. Thank you for listening to all the presentations.